This is Yunnan, where nature has carved out exceptional mountains and rivers that are home to incredible biodiversity. We've traveled here to explore these landscapes and get a closer look at the creatures they hold. Why do they exist? And where do they come from? And why are we so alike and yet so different? Follow me as we explore this fascinating biological world, from the most bizarre to the most magnificent. Earth, one of the countless planets in the universe. So what makes it unique? Water. Water gave birth to the first life forms on Earth, formed the magnificent and colorful biodiversity in front of us, and also gave birth to human civilization. Yunnan is home to multiple complex water systems, and one of the provinces with the largest number of lakes in China. More than 600 rivers act as arteries, carrying precious lifeblood. The star-studded plateau lakes shine like pearls. Well, my first experience in Yunnan was 12 meters down in Fuxian Lake, which was absolutely stunning. The lake is incredibly clear, a lot of sunlight coming down through, a lot of beautiful colors. Fuxian Lake is the deepest plateau freshwater lake in China. Formed in the Pliocene period about 3.4 million years ago, this plateau lake was shaped alongside the creation of the Yunnan Plateau.
Okay，有问题啊，哪里有问题指哪里。我任何时候问你 OK，你 OK 的话你就回我 OK，不 OK。有姿势，哪里不舒服就指给我看就好了啊。看他是什么姿势。看到就这样，我会跟你说。有一点紧张。Plateau lakes are relatively closed off, so the water flow is relatively slow. It's a great place for a beginner like me. But as a closed system, the management of water quality is key, especially for aquatic organisms that co-evolve with the lakes. Even a small change in the aquatic environment will affect all the living things that make their home here. My underwater exploration of Fuxian Lake is full of surprises. That was a magical experience. This lake is crystal clear, and down there the quality with the sunlight beaming down through all of that seaweed or grass in the lake was absolutely stunning. There were little stonefish, little shrimp. Really, I think I'm ready to go down again. Water is key to life. 500 million years ago, Yunnan used to be a vast sea. Hundreds of creatures developed here. It was the staging grounds for an explosion of life.
Earth has 46 亿年的历史，那么这46亿年呢，只分作两个部分，一个叫隐生宙，一个叫显生宙。 那么隐生宙的时候呢，地球上的生命呢，其实已经有30多亿年了，但是一直都是单调的、单一的。 由单细胞到多细胞是一些细菌和蓝藻，
就没什么。嗯，
没有什么。突然到了寒武纪的时候呢，就出现了生物多样性的事件，爆发式的出现。
The World National Heritage Museum of Chengjiang Fossil Site is unique, even among its peers. It stands atop the only location on Earth where fossils from almost every evolutionary period have been discovered.
这里呢是地球寒武纪生命大爆发的最重要的见证。我们仔细看，这里有一个化石，它是一个三叶虫。
哦，我看到了，就那个。
在5亿多年前，这里呢就是一个汪洋大海，大海里面呢生活着我们今天地球上所有动物的祖先们。
Life forms from ancient times are collected and displayed in the museum, creating an incredible array. This fascinating sight is unlike anything I've seen.Thanks to a beautiful explanation from the museum's curator, I'm able to get a better understanding of the origins of Earth's biodiversity.
这个呢，就是咱们的澄江化石。嗯。这样的小化石呢，它好像是不太起眼，但是我告诉您，它代表了化石最高的保存质量。
什么？
就是因为正常情况下，我们能看到的化石必须是坚硬的东西才能形成的，
是
比如说恐龙的骨头。
对对对 对。
但是澄江化石是一个特例，因为它保留下来的不只是那些硬的，更多的它保留的软躯体的结构，比如说像肌肉，像它的这个眼睛，像它的大脑，粪便，甚至胃里边没有消化的食物，都完好的保留下来了。
有意思。
因为它的保存非常的完整啊，所以科学家呢就对它进行分类的工作。那么通过分类就发现，哎，这些生物到今天为止有20个门，280多个物种，那么涵盖了我们今天地球上所有动物的祖先。所以我们说，哎，这里是地球动物谱系树之根，然后它是地球多样性的源头。您可以拿这个模型放在这个感应台上。
哦，是出来了。真棒。
比如说是它的外观是这样。然后我们把它复原之后呢，哎，它就呈现了这样的样子。它的身体的形态，它运动的方式，包括身体的一些细节呢，哎，都可以清晰的看得出来。那么这条鱼呢，就是昆明鱼，
昆明鱼，
我们人类的5亿年前的共同的祖先。
It began with Kunming fish. The fish came ashore and evolved into amphibians. Amphibians left the water for good and became reptiles. Reptiles evolved into mammals during the Cretaceous period. Among them was the rapid rise of primates. We humans belong to this branch.More than 500 million years since the Cambrian period, life on Earth has continued to flourish, creating the incredible diversity we see today. This museum has a wall that displays all kinds of shell fossils. These numerous aquatic fossils show the wonders of Earth's biodiversity. They also help to preserve the story of evolution on our planet.One of the fossil hunters, Wang Xiaodong, will take me on a journey to find fossils. This is a small village not far from Kunming Dianchu Lake.
这个墙就是各种螺丝在土里面的。
我们当地的这些老百姓很多都是用泥土就地取材来盖的这个房屋。正好呢，这个地方是以前古人类的遗址，就是丢弃了大量的螺壳，他们就把含有这种螺壳的泥土取出来作为建筑材料，然后盖成了房屋。结果呢，风吹日晒雨淋啊，这个表面的土呢脱落了，就剩下这些坚硬的螺壳。而且这 这里边的螺丝呢，我们现在可以看到呢，有两到三种啊，可以看到这种带流突的，还可以看到这种带刺的、啊。
嗯哼。These tiny shells make it easy to see the richness and diversity of shellfish in this area since ancient times. However, these shells here are only 2,000 to 3,000 years old. They're what we call subfossils. So what do older fossils look like, and what about their ancestors?
云南的高原湖泊都是很古老的，那么我就会有意识的去找一些就是比较有可能出现远古的古湖的地方。
Mr. Wang took me to another village, a relatively deserted area surrounded by farmland.
啊，这有一个田螺的化石。
OK。
啊，是这里发现的啊，最古老的田螺的化石。
这个是一个大石头，就是在盖房子的时候，他把切开来，完了就盖着这栋楼。
哎，对，这一套地层呢是属于第三纪晚期的，至少是300万年前的。
嗯哼。
但是呢，一般有可能是500,000-600,000年或者更早的700多万年啊。
嗯。
所以这个田螺是非常古老的。
不管怎么样，几百年。
对，
几百万年。
对，
几百万年。
极有可能是现身的这个，所有这个云南这些螺丝的，祖先之一啊。
I would never have imagined that I would be hunting for fossils that were built into the side of a house. We are going to these dilapidated houses and finding old stones they used as building materials that have fossils in them that are 3 million years old.
啊，那像这里呢就有很多这种荒废的，对，你看。
哦，这就有。
对，这里就有了。对，像这个上面有很多。
嗯哼，
这个也是。这个也是，这些都可以用锤子砸开看一看。
嗯。Look at that. More than 1 million years old. A sea snail or a water snail, actually, because there's no sea here. Right? It came from a lake, and just it seems that every brick of a house and stone that you see in a wall here.Seems to have a fossil in it. It's like a, wow! It's like a fossil heaven here. It's incredible. 哇 ，Look at that！
哇，这个呢是它的螺尖儿啊，另外一个，这个比较完整。对，我们当然它露出来的大部分可以看到有螺尖儿，还有这个体螺层啊都在了啊，
几百万年。
对对对，你可以看到啊，这个呢就。在光滑的基础上呢，它长出了一条这个，明显的长出了一条轮。我们一般把这种田螺呢叫做流田螺。这一类田螺呢，一般它的公认的时间呢，可能要比这些光滑的要晚一些。您找的这个螺丝的，你看，就是从光滑的一直到长出轮，再到这个有流突或者。壳是复杂的，甚至我们在这儿还找到有长出了刺的啊，就是说它是有一个从简单的壳式，一直到复杂的壳式这么转变的。
From the smooth shells of 3 million years ago to spiral shells to spiky ones, Mr. Wang walked me through the evolution of freshwater snails. It really paints a picture of just how steeped in biodiversity our history is.A lot of his shells had actually gone to this museum that we went to in Changjiang. So just through his passion for shells, he's managed to see how evolution has transformed the shellfish. Some people use fossils from different ages to study the evolution of living things, while others are looking for living evidence of biological evolution.Water is not only a life giver, but also a sculptor, shaping the earth as it moves. Karst systems,
formed by the erosion of limestone and other similar minerals, are home to cave-dwelling creatures. Yunnan, located in the karst region of southwest China, touts the most concentrated cave distribution in the world, with one of the richest areas of cave biodiversity. In Yilian County, Kunming, I meet with Yu Zhichen, a cave explorer. There are huge karst caves in Jiuxiang, Yilian. Most of these caves are connected to underground rivers. And if you follow them upstream, they will take you to a secret place.
Hey, 这个是咱们最后能看到光线吗？
对，再往里走就灵光线了。
是吧？不会吧？
对对对，把帽子给戴上。
嗯，到那儿有什么危险呢？因为说实话，我还比较恐怖那种，地儿小，知道吗？
里面的话就是，你个特别高，
嗯，
首先你地要反转，
嗯哼，
就是特别小的洞我不建议进，好吧？
但
其次的话就是说，眼看马上就要下雨了，
嗯，
然后水位可能会上涨。
Okay.
就原计划膝盖的水位可能会到肩膀哦。
啊！
Deep in the cave, it is a dark but magnificent world. Over millennia, small water droplets slowly carve away and shape this underground world.
This 上面，它会最后就连接到那下面了。
对对，钟乳石的话就从上滴水下来。上下都是沉积，这里湿度非常大嘛，在上面会汇集成水滴，它有棱角的地方它就开始往下滴，它滴的有可能很慢，可能几小时甚至几天才滴一次，对，你看着这个其实不高，但它如果要连在一起的话要上千年，
是吗？
对对对，很不容易，上面就是会有亮晶晶的小白点，看着像珍珠会反光，对吧？
是，
那个其实是水滴，
那就是水，
对，是水滴，它其实很漂亮，就亮晶晶的半圆形，
哇。
While humans are naturally afraid of darkness and long for light, other life thrives in the absence of light.
老姜，你看那里有只藏马，
嗯，
它是一种蟋蟀，
嗯，
这个虫子的话外面也有，但是呢，这里面的话它会缺少阳光照，
嗯，
它会开始白化。你看，注意看它的肚皮，是不是可以看到它的那个肠子、内脏，是不是？你注意看，它的大腿也开始有点白化了。
哦，它在边侧。
对，这个洞里面的话，它除了藏马蜥以外的话，还会有马鹿、蜈蚣、蝙蝠这些小的昆虫动物、嗯。然后除了之外，还会有一些植物也是白化的，你要注意看。对，因为这个里面太缺光线了，
嗯，
你得慢慢发现。
Search carefully and you will find many magical creatures living in this seemingly lonely cave. We walked into the darkness without stopping, hoping to meet some of the residents.
Yu 老师，Yu 老师。
对，看到了是吧？
对，
他这个他视力不太好，但他游得特别快，他那个嗅觉和那个这个感应程度会非常好。
你把那碗给我，
碗吗？好嘞，来，
我试试啊。
OK， 你得把碗绕到他头前面。
碗在前边。Come on, fishy, come here。
注意啊，会越走越深啊，前面。
有
有
，OK。厉害，两次就逮到了。可以量一下它的尺寸，
小。
等一下，
非常小。
可以拍一下有多少公分？有七公分，7.2。这个的话是一条稍微有眼睛的鱼。嗯。如果它能形成一个闭合的生态链的话，那里发现的鱼就是白化的。
白化的。
对对对对对，这条的话就稍微
它是有一个
有一点点白，说明对对对，说明它在这个洞穴里已经生活了一段时间，
是吧？
就没有受到紫外线关照，就开始褪色了。
These blind albino fish are living biological proof that life will find a way. These cave ecosystems were once ignored because of how difficult they are to reach. Nowadays, it is thanks to the efforts of more and more explorers like Mr. Yu that these rich and unique species can be seen by the public eye. Cave-dwelling ecosystems have become the new global biodiversity hotspot.Deep in those caves as well, it was nice to sit down with the kind of new generation of Chinese adventurers. He's inspiring and a whole new generation of Chinese explorers to go to these caves. Deep in a limestone cave was surreal, but at the same time, incredibly inspiring. As burrowing creatures struggle to adapt themselves to their environment, in Dali, Yunnan province,One lucky group of animals have found the home of their dreams. Jianhu Lake is extremely old and it's beginning to dry up. But in doing so, it has created a wetland of sorts, rich in diverse plant and animal life.Yangting is a local and of the Bai ethnic group, and she grew up here near Jianhu Lake.
This is your today's day班的穿你们这个应该是白族的衣服。
白族的衣服，
特别好看。嗯，没错吧？
板蓝根染出来的颜色就是蓝色。
每个家庭有他自己的一个蓝色，我记得是。
啊，对的，对的，对的。
这个湖我确实是头一次来。嗯。第一，感觉非常安静。嗯。二是这个生物多样性非常丰富，有鸟啊，有各种植物啊。
5300多年前就已经有白族的先民临水而居，我们就是围着这个湖长大的。这些一个一个的村落，全都是我们白族人的房子，我们自己的家。
是吗？
嗯，对对对。
5300年。
5,300 years for nature is just a speck in its life cycle.But for humans, it's a very long time. All through this time, the Bai people have continued to guard this aging mother lake. They've put in a lot of hard work, directing water flow, controlling pollution, and banning fishing. They are attempting to give this lake the best twilight years possible.
We're always talking.一直能听到各种鸟，
对，各种鸟叫声，鸟非常的多。
你还能
彩环啊，灰鹤呀、
啊。哦，你还能听出来哪个是哪个？
黑鹳啊，紫水鸡，对对对。
为什么叫它鸡呢？
但其实它是鸟，它外形看上去有点像鸡，
是吗？
非常漂亮的一只鸟，穿着紫色的小裙子，戴着一个小红帽。嗯。它高颜值的这个外表下，配了一双非常大的脚。嗯。这个脚呢，就是便于它在水面上的水草上站立，因为这个鸟它不会下水去捕鱼。
哦，它不下水的。哦，
也不会下水，也不会捕鱼。它没有扑。刺菱角、浮萍、焦草等等等等植物，它都吃。这些植物的这些嫩茎嫩叶都是它喜爱的，或者是小昆虫。水面上漂浮的这些昆虫以植物为主。
对。
小虫啊，这些小蜥蜴、小蜘蛛。这些为主。
The oddly named purple swamp hen is known as the most beautiful water bird in the world. You can spot them from far away, especially when the sun shines through the clouds. It will reflect their bright colors, blues, greens, and purples, beautiful and dazzling.
第一次发现的时候是1995年，它是外来的。但是它目前呢已经是繁殖到了1600多只。占了那个云南省的1/3，全国的一半的紫水鸡都在咱们建湖。
所以被保护得非常好，
非常好。因为我们鉴湖它保护好了之后，它的这个生态环境非常适合紫水鸡在这边生存。紫水鸡现在不是候鸟，它已经变成了留鸟了。就在这里安营扎寨了。在这儿安家了。
所以它也不是一个候鸟，它就是在这儿定居的。
对，在这儿定居。
它就莫名其妙飞过来，有一天完了一直没走。
是的，对对对对对。
And it's a very interesting story because the birds came to the lake as migratory birds just to stay for the spring or the summer and then would leave. But eventually they found that the temperature and the climate and the food and the plants and everything in the lake was so suited to them that they stayed and they multiplied, made this beautiful old lake their home for life.Leaving Dali, we will drive 450 kilometers to one of the most beautiful places on Earth. There lies a lake with the highest elevation in Yunnan province. People call it the Tears of the Goddess. The Mosaw people, the only minority group in China that still maintains a matriarchal lifestyle,live by Lugu Lake. There, I meet a local man, Ge Sang.
Sang 哥，你看，这有好多好多的这种水花呢。
这个它不叫水花，我们这里呢，很多人叫东方女儿国，因为我们这里是最后一个母系部落，所以说这是我们女儿国的国花，很有名的。
Okay.
本地人叫海藻花，或者游客叫的水性杨花，太阳的杨。你会看到，因为刚才出了会太阳，你看这个花就完全的打开了。
所以其实它也不是说一年四季都这样开，
不是，
就是到这个季节，
就这个季节，而且每一天就这个时候开，两三点可能就没了。从三月份到这个八九月是这个的花期，最多的、最漂亮的是七八月啊，
okay.
这个期间。
We were extremely lucky because when we arrived, the flowers on the lake were in full bloom, a sea full of flowers. However, the more beautiful things are, the harder they are to obtain. These flowers are extremely finicky. They are referred to as the judges of water quality. If there is even the slightest hint of water pollution, they will disappear without a trace.
这个水是非常非常清的，就是能看到最下边，完了水草非常非常多。
以前的话，这是一种食物啊，这个花，你看花骨朵还有那个根茎，我们人可以拿来去吃，可以去炒，可以去烫火锅，还可以凉拌，
是吧？
对，可以的，
还能凉拌的。
然后下面你看那个叶子，很茂密的叶子，到了冬天，我们这儿高原比较冷，那些绿色的植物呢就没有了，我们就把这个割回去。拿去喂猪，现在呢我们近期保护嘛，就不能捕鱼，不能钓鱼，包括这个海菜花我们就不能搞了，所以才有这么漂亮的花海啊。
整个这个湖都是保护，现在
都是保护，
就动都不能动，
鱼都不能钓了，这个草不能动，
这个水可以在里面，也不允许什么游泳啊什么这些，
这些不可以了，现在不行了，只能在上面划我们这种小猪槽船，而且要纯手工划，没有任何机动污染的这种，
怪不得那么轻，偶尔还能看到很大的一条鱼能游过去
对，
这个鱼也不能钓，
鱼也不能钓，也不能捕就是禁海十年，暂保护十年。
In the past, the Mosaw people made a living by farming and fishing. Now, in order to protect the ecological environment here.They are willing to change their way of life that has been passed down for thousands of years. This is by no means a simple thing. Water is a gift given by the universe to allow for life on Earth. The Chinese have a strong affection for water. More than 2,500 years ago, the Chinese philosopher Lao Tzu wrote a famous quote about water. 上善若水。Which means water is good for all things, but does not compete. Water is both gentle and powerful, and it represents the Chinese people's desire for the best of humanity. Today, in Yunnan Province, China, people protect and love water,
because from water comes all life.